to This Week at River Ridge, and thanks for keeping up with us week after week. If you're wondering why I have such a big belly this week, it's because I'm participating in the Con Ed Baby Project that every senior has to do for Ms. Lord's class in order to graduate.
This week, we will be discussing the ICTM math results from Saturday. We'll have a report on the Taste of Elizabeth, as well as another Gossip Girl session.
The ICTM participants were extremely successful last weekend. The team took third overall. The state qualifiers that will be advancing include the fresh, soft, 8-person team who won first place, the calculator team who won first place, Sam and Corey on the 2-person team who won a first place, the junior, senior, 8-person team, Noel Reese individually won third and will be advancing for the geometry team, the pre-calculus 6-person team who took 6 individual tests combined for a total winning score. And these are the qualifiers that wrap up the state qualifiers. The geometry team got second and is still waiting for results on whether or not they will advance to state. The fresh soft 2-person team will also be waiting to see if they will advance. Here is Carrie with a member of ICTM on how the event went.
Thanks, Alyssa. I'm here with Marcelo Diaz, a member from the ICTM group. So what does ICTM stand for?
Illinois Council of Teachers of Mathematics.
And where was the competition?
At Rock Valley College in Rockford.
And how did you guys do?
Fairly well, overall.
Good. Now back to the girls in the newsroom.
Last Saturday, community members came out to support the town of Elizabeth's mapping program. It was a fabulous turnout. Presentations were given on projects that have already taken place, as well as future plans for town improvement. All food and desserts were quite the hit. Thanks for everyone who made this night possible. And now here's to Kelly with an interview of someone who was at the event.
Thanks, Kelsey. I'm here with Coach Nick. And you went to the Elizabeth Town Meeting. How do you think the mapping is going?
Yeah, I did go to the meeting. I thought it was very good. It was nice to see that many people there, to see that they care about Elizabeth, to see that things are going in the right direction.
And how was the Taste of Elizabeth food?
It was awesome. I recommend it to anybody. I think they're going to do it again next year. Great restaurants in there, great food. It was fun to be at.
That's great. And are you excited for mapping for the future of Elizabeth?
I think it's a great idea. It lets people know that the community cares, that the village is trying to be proactive and get things to the town. So I think it's great.
Thank you. Now back to the girls in the newsroom.
Thanks, Kelly. And now here's to our Gossip Girl session of the week.
Welcome back to the Gossip Girl section for this week, featuring Heb. Today's topic of discussion will be Miss Lord's baby projects.
There's a lot of controversy over whether or not the project makes sense or we should do it at all. And I personally think it doesn't hurt you to try the belly out for 2 days, it's not too long, and see how it feels to actually be carrying a baby. It doesn't hurt or help. Some people think it doesn't help you, but I sure don't think it hurts you. So you might as well do it.
Well, I think like a lot of us babysit, so we all kind of know, like, how's taking this little plastic baby doll around for like 2 days or 3 days, however long it is, how's that teaching you anything about children? You should just go out and babysit. And
what if people don't have an opportunity to babysit?
Well, they need, Mr. Fry's always looking for people. I see him hunting down people all day. So like, they should instead of that have a program where like you need like 5 hours of like babysitting time, like volunteer, not even being paid, and that should be the project.
Okay. I don't think it's a bad idea. I think it should be more for preparation rather than teaching how you take care of kids, so it should probably be earlier than senior year, but I understand they want it to teach kids how to parent instead of prevent it.
How can it teach kids how to do it, though, if all you're doing is taking a plastic baby, putting your hand over it, and then changing the diaper?
Because it's the idea of it.
Did you like having the baby?
No.
Exactly. You didn't like it. Did you like being pregnant?
No.
Exactly. So that's what it's teaching us girls. We don't like that right now in this stage of our life. We don't like going home after homework and sports and staying up all night caring for a baby. So it's teaching us girls and boys how to care for a baby after our busy high school.
Plus, how it feels to be pregnant.
But why would you willingly do that at this age?
Not all girls pay for it. What teenage girl do you know that has a baby that says, yep, I wanted to be pregnant?
Exactly.
Pretty sure they all happen
exactly.
On accident.
So
why should we do
you.
The project?
It's preventing you.
We already know.
To make you think it's twice.
Gonna,
like, this is how it's going to be.
Okay, before this gets any worse, I think we're just going to sum it up. Enjoy the senior baby project in Ms. Lord's class and let us know what you think on the topic.
So what do you think of the baby project?
It's definitely not my favorite project I've done in my high school career.
Well, it's not my favorite thing ever, but I understand how important it is.
I guess it's all right. Why are you even asking me this question?
So what does it feel like to be pregnant?
It sucks.
Well, it's definitely a lot different carrying newfound 30 pounds and trying not to run your belly into things.
What are you talking about? Why are you thinking I'm pregnant?
What does it feel like to carry all the weight?
It's really hard because my back and my shoulders hurt a lot.
Well, my back definitely hurts, and I feel like I'm walking kind of funny, so.
You know, these questions are out of line, all right?
When are you expecting the baby?
I have the baby this Friday until Monday.
I have the baby March 14th until the 17th.
The same time?
Ready?
Yeah, okay, no five. Laughing.
Two.
Bananas!
All right, Mike.
Hope you enjoyed our Gossip Girls section this week. Now here's sports.
Thanks, girls. So because girls' basketball is done, all the focus has shifted to the boys' basketball team this week. So Katie, how are they doing?
The boys have finally began the regional week and started out with a tough game against Galena Pirates. The boys played hard and the game was close, right to the end. Thankfully, the boys pulled it out and ended with a score of 51-45. Also, we would like to congratulate Brendan Dauphin for reaching his 1,000th point in his varsity career during that game. The boys then played their second game in regionals against the Warren Warriors. After another very close game, the boys pulled out a big win with the scores of 43-59. The boys will now play tonight at Warren again against the East Dubuque Warriors. Come out and cheer them on.
Thanks, Katie, but we actually got news that the final score of the Riveridge Warren game was 49-43. But thanks, Katie, and now back to the girls in the newsroom. Thanks, guys, and now here's to Lauren with this week's weather.
Thanks, guys. If you haven't noticed, we've entered a polar vortex again. Yesterday, we had a high of 0. Yes, 0. Today's high is approximately 13 with a low of 1, 30% chance of snow. Saturday is a high of 10 and a low of 2, 40% chance of snow. On Sunday, it's a high of 19 and a low of 2, 40% chance of snow again. And on Monday, it's approximately a high of 22 and a low of 2, 30% chance of snow or more. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Lauren. Now here's to current events.
Hi, we're current events. I'm Micah.
And I'm Jacob. Just recently, a couple in Northern California found a bunch of gold coins that were worth $10
million. $10
million? Yes, that is a lot. And the coins were rated in $5, $10, and $20 increments, which date back into the 1800s.
Wish that was me. Just recently in Ukraine, dozens and dozens of people are dying as protesters protest the government,
wow,
saying that they want a new president, right?
Yeah.
So many people dying. The president of Ukraine has sent police forces to fight the protesters, but as protesters widen their control, the president of Ukraine has fled the palace and his whereabouts are unknown.
That is diabolical.
Right? Now back to the newsroom.
Thanks, boys. And now to Erin with our announcements for the week.
Thanks, girls. And for this week's announcements, we have some big news. We're expecting!
Just kidding.
Okay, bye. Bye, Ashley. Okay, so the actual announcements are, sophomores, your class trip is coming up, and you need to be here at 4:50 to leave at 5. Yes, in the morning. Okay, seniors, if you don't have your pictures in Ms. Smith for the slideshow by Friday, you will not be in it. These people are missing their pictures. Carter, Hannah, Caitlin Mapes, Ryan, Marshall, Morgan, and Corey. Western Civ, you have a test coming up next Thursday. And remember, we are holding sectionals. Let's hope the boys make it so we can cheer them on. Back to you, girls.
Thanks, Erin. Now to Mr. Vanigo's joke of the week.
Hey, that joke was pretty funny.
No, it wasn't.
Okay. Have a fun weekend and start preparing for all those spring sports.
Thanks for watching, and we'll try to do better next week.
Well, you can tell everybody. Yeah, you can tell everybody. Go ahead and tell everybody.
I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the man. Yes, I am, yes, I am, yes, I am. I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the man. I believe every lie that I ever told. Paid for every heart that I ever stole. I played my cards and I didn't fold. Well, it ain't that hard when you got sold. Somewhere I heard that life is a test. I've been through the worst, but I still get my best. God made my mold different from the rest. Then he broke that mold, so I know I'm blessed. Stand up now and face the sun. Won't hide my tail or turn and